What is going on, everybody? Depraved Slash here. We are back with another music reaction. I'm Depraved.
I'm Hellcat.
And together we are...
Hella Depraved.
Yes, we are. So, we are super stoked. We are on the third track that's dropping today.
Right.
For Evanescence. In our day of Evanescence.
Continuing down our album.
Our day of Amy Lee.
Yes.
And her bandmates / friends.
I'm excited to be here. I'm so glad this album came out. It's been absolutely fantastic so far.
I have liked every song off of it so far.
Yeah, there hasn't been one that I won't listen to over and over and over. And I will say that I traditionally like almost every song on an Evanescence album, and have in the past. But, you know, there's always a couple that you're just like, oh, that was decent. That was good. That was good. You know, I don't think there's ever been one that I've been like, yeah, I'll just pass that one, or I'll skip it a whole bunch, or, you know, but there's definitely been sort of a tier list of favorites and a gradient. This one has been like, no, I can't even call a favorite so far. He has, but... I haven't been able to. Yeah. All right, so the next one is...
Broken Pieces Shine.
All right.
Super excited. Got the lyrics pulled up on our phone. I've been sitting here scrolling all goofy-like because I need to move my fingers.
Yeah, I know. You're a fidgeter.
I am.
And out of the corner of my eye, it's, you know. Anyway, we're going to react to this as though you guys have already heard it.
And if you have not, go listen.
Please
go stream the... Not stream. Yeah, stream. Stream the entire album if that's how you have to do it. Spotify,
or
Tidal.
Or buy your own.
You know, all those fun things.
Yeah, yeah.
YouTube. I'm sure there's got to be a lyric video for all these up somewhere.
Somebody's got them up, but I'm positive that she has, you know, at least just the audio.
Right.
Yeah.
And then come on back. And we say that because we're a breakdown channel. We're going to talk about the lyrics. We pause them quite a bit, so.
Right.
With that being said, ladies and gentlemen, song number 3 on Hell's Request Strand. This is Broken Pieces Shine. It is time to slash it up and break it down. Let's get it. Let me actually do it right this time. I messed up last time. He said 3, 2, 1, 0.
I did catch that.
Just making sure.
Lift off.
Just making sure.
Yeah, I did catch that. Yeah, yeah.
Okay.
There is no way back this time. What is real? What is mine?
Now, they have this all funkily broke up. It's like verse 1, verse 2. That was one verse, y'all. Come on.
Yeah.
Come on, genius lyric people. Figure your shit out. All right. So she said, there is no way back this time. Actually, she said, start off 3, 2, 1, 0. And then she said, there
is... your favorite part, no.
There is no way back this time. What is real and what is mine? Oh, survival hurts. I won't draw that out again. Lose myself or lose my mind every time I close my eyes. oh, survival hurts. But I keep breathing in. I'm alive. I'm not fine. I don't know if I'll be all right, but I have to try. I know you're with me, so what if we do fall apart, give in to all that we are, and let the broken pieces shine. 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 Ooh. I love this song.
So I heard...
I have a new favorite.
Portions of the lyrics. Of course, you know, the first time that you hear something, a lot of times you may or may not catch every single lyric.
Right.
Especially when it comes to kind of, well, Amy Lee's voice plus the rock music, there's such a strong desire to just vibe out and listen to awesomeness.
Just listen to her voice.
Yeah, but, man, those are some poignant lyrics. And what I was getting at is that just hearing you read them, and I hate to say it, baby, but it was not your... dramatic flair that gave me the chills.
I tried.
it was the extended ooze that you did for all of us here. But I like how this whole thing is phrased. Surviving hurts. I mean, I think we are now in an age. Well, I think it's a human tendency to glorify survival. And I'm not saying that surviving through traumas is anything to scoff about, guys. That's not what I'm saying. I'm saying that we try and take away the ugly and just say that we're a survivor and that makes us inherently strong and... But while we will talk about what we had to survive hurting, we don't talk about that the actual surviving hurts and that it is something that you're constantly sort of struggling with to not focus on or not remember the things that you had to survive to be here. So it's not something that you just completely heal from, and it's never there, and you never struggle with it
right
going forward.
Well, if you think of it from a similar perspective, when we're born, we're born with this sense of wonder and nothing could go wrong,
right?
And then you get older and you start to meet new people. They become your friends. Friendships die for one reason or another, betrayal. And it's like from that moment, and even sometimes, even younger, because sometimes parents can have that effect on their kids where...
they aren't the protectors they're supposed to be, or...
Yeah. Right. So, you kind of start breaking piece by piece.
You do?
And it goes from friendships to family members passing away, heartbreak.
Right.
And that's why I like the lyrics that she said, where she's like, let all the broken pieces shine. Because that's life. Life is pain.
Right.
Life is one emotional scar after another.
Right.
And at that point, it's just how you move on from it.
Right, how you...
or cope with it, I guess.
I think with the shining, it's more like coming to peace, coming to terms with who you are despite all of those pieces, and realizing that those pieces are what makes you you, and right. that you're still worth shining. Now, the way that the broken pieces shine reminds me of the... what is it, the Japanese art of, where they take, like, broken bowls and stuff like that, and they re-weld them back together with gold. And it's actually a desirable thing, because that means that every single piece is unique in its own right, but it's also beautiful. And
right.
You are literally making the broken pieces shine. But that does make each of us a unique story. And right. A unique person with different perspective. And honestly, if we were all able to communicate without take it like, I don't know, logically and emotionally and maturely communicate without that being a point of dissension, we all have such incredible stories and different viewpoints that it just, I think it would make the world absolutely, I don't know, just, it's so interesting to me. And I think we could do so much good together. And yet a lot of people obviously can't get along in the same room. I do like your perspective on it because it you're talking about just living as being the survival instead of like a couple factors of things that hit you in your life, like just making it day to day is survival. Right. So yeah.
Alrighty. Jazz Patron ad right in the middle of these lyrics. Shuttered inside, looking out, everything's turned upside down. Oh, we're not the first. How can we ever be us, wondering who we can trust? Oh, survival hurts. But I'm not giving in, I'm alive. I'm not fine, I don't know if I will be alright, but I have to try. I know you're with me, so what if we do fall apart, give in to all that we are, and let all the broken pieces come alive?
Yeah, again, the portion about, like, I'm...
Did I move you again? My beautiful reading. That's Shakespearean, isn't it?
Very, very. You
or more Bernstein.
You have a flair for
or
this.
Or Bernstein? Is it Bernstein? I think it's Bernstein. Dry red eyes.
But the parts about, like, I'm not fine. Like, it's... Again, you're not trying to gloss over it. You're not trying to hide that survival hurts. That there has been a rocky road. There's no need to, I don't know, keep it behind closed doors. However, those are the pieces of you that you're now shining from. But it's, I mean, it actually ties into what you were saying. After the first verse about the whole, like, how, if you can't trust anybody, how are you ever supposed to be yourself? Because it's very hard to open yourself up and actually show all of the things that people could consider weird or different about you if you can't trust anybody, especially if you keep expecting them to betray you or spread your confidence around, you know, that kind of thing. It's very hard to be yourself.
You were summing up her interview pretty nicely, by the way.
Her interview?
It's genius. So there's things you can click on. Remember when I was looking for that yesterday for a song?
Oh, okay. All right.
And when you click into it, it says, Amy's telling us to be who we truly are, which is a theme of the whole album.
Okay. All right.
She said in an interview from September of last year.
Okay. So, guys,
the album's called The Bitter Truth for a reason. It's not about showing your prettiest side. It's about showing your realest inside and being more of your true self on the outside at any cost.
Okay. Yeah. Something we said yesterday that we'll just reiterate. We don't do research before coming into this. We try and avoid most write-ups, definitely any interviews, stuff like that in case of spoilers. And it wouldn't be an honest reaction if we did that much research. I do know some people do everything but listen to the song ahead of time. But again, I just don't feel like we can give you interpretation that we originally take from it when we do that.
And I feel like a lot of music is interpretation.
Well, that's... I've said that. I think that's why music is universal, is each of us have our own first take on what it means to us.
Right.
And I think that, like, after listening to this album, guys, I absolutely will go and re-listen to interviews that she's given and everything, because I want to hear her perspective on it. And I like, you know, just taking in that information, and it adds to my interpretation, but I want my own personal thoughts and feelings on it first. So.
Right.
Don't breathe. That was gorgeous.
Yes. Yes. I take back not being able to pick a favorite. So, guys, we've covered all of the singles that have been released so far, and this is the third that we've listened to that has not been released as a single prior to the whole album release. And up until this point, they were all so great and on an even playing field for me. Both because the lyrics have been so poignant, the empowerment behind this whole album, the strength that she's displaying just as a person saying, you know, take me as I am and, you know, move over. However, this song, lyrically, I mean, the whole thing, but lyrically, this song hits me the hardest. Like, I feel like I take the most relevance from this. Does actually make me kind of tear up a bit. So, yeah, this one is definitely my favorite one. I need you to cry on camera for me.
That's just ever so slightly mean.
I did it. It's your turn.
That's true.
No. I absolutely love this song. It's lyrically, like you said, probably the most poignant out of all of them for me.
Right. Just personally, like, I still stand by Use My Voice, being one that has just relevance, I think, to everybody. And a message that we all need to hear. We needed to hear when it was released, but we absolutely need to continue having that message reinforced. But personally, I do think that this should be a widespread message in terms of, like, not everybody is supposed to be the same. And you should be proud of who you are simply because you've made it this far. But, because of my past and my personal life, this song is the most touching to me.
Yes. Yeah. All right, guys. So that is going to do it. If you guys like the video, slash that like button, subscribe, ring the bell for notifications. Comment down below. What did you think of Evanescence with Broken Pieces Shine? Also, comment down below if there's anything else you guys want to see reacted to. Check the description below for all the things.
Push our buttons. Come join us on our other social media platforms, mostly Twitter, if you want a quicker response.
With that being said, we love you guys. Thank you all for watching. Cannot wait to see you depraved people later.